Republican Senator Lindsey Graham saying there may be a breakthrough tonight in talks to end the U.S. government shutdown. Ryan Nobles is back with me now on Capitol Hill. So, Ryan, he talked to reporters. What did he say?
Yeah, that's right, Frederica. So Senator Graham, among a group of about 20 or so Republicans and Democrats, mostly moderate, in Senator Susan Collins' office right now, trying to come up with some sort of a breakthrough as it relates to ending this government shutdown. And Senator Graham gaggled with reporters before he went in the room, and he did sound a bit optimistic of where the negotiations are headed. Take a listen to what Senator Graham had to say.
Hey, everybody.
Senator Graham, can you tell us about your progress in this bipartisan?
More people are interested in the solution, but sort of here's the state of the play, kind of to play by play for football. Mitch McConnell's proposal to go to February the 8th with the understanding that we're going to work on all issues outstanding, including immigration, should be enough to get Democratic support. I believe that what will happen is that if we work together, we'll find a solution. But come February the 8th, I think we need a commitment that we're going to go to immigration to get this issue solved once and for all. I hope the White House will come on board, but the Senate needs to lead because no one else is. In terms of the White House staff, I think, is making it very difficult. I enjoy working with them, but let me give you two examples of the problem. There was a handout given to the bipartisan group last Tuesday where the president did a masterful job on television for 55 minutes regarding border security. It was a very detailed border security plan that I could support in phase two, but not phase one. The president looked at it and said, who did this? You know, this is way too much. I didn't approve this. Then we also heard the president say that the $18 billion request for border security was too much. I could do it for less, and I think you can. So what does the White House staff do a couple of days later? They pitch a proposal for $33 billion. So that's just not credible. I've talked with the president. His heart is right on this issue. I think he's got a good understanding of what will sell. And every time we have a proposal, it is only yanked back by staff members. As long as Stephen Miller is in charge of negotiating immigration, we're going nowhere. He's been an outlier for years. There's a deal to be had. DACA plus for more border security funding. I heard Chuck Schumer say that he agreed to more wall funding, which I think is absolutely appropriate. And we're going to have to do something with legal immigration increases because we don't have the workers we need. So I think there will be a breakthrough tonight. If there's going to be one, it will be tonight. It will go sort of like this. We're going to agree to fund the government through February the 8th. With the understanding we're going to work on all the outstanding issues, including immigration, which is a gift for Mitch McConnell. And if we can't find a resolution, hopefully we'll turn to immigration in an open process. Rand Paul said something today I agree with. We need to bring immigration bills to the floor and let the Senate work its will. We need the president's support. We'll need the House's support. But somebody's got to lead, and I think the Senate is the perfect body to do that.
Senator, have you won over any Democrats, new members that you didn't have on Friday?
I think more and more Democrats are believing this is not playing well for them. I want to applaud Mitch McConnell for showing a compromise different than the House. I voted no because I thought 30 days was too long. My point was, let's pick a shorter period of time. But what good does it do to open the government if the government doesn't work? So what Mitch has done is made a promise to shorten the time to February the 8th and a commitment that we're going to work in a bipartisan fashion on all the issues, disaster, budget, including immigration. I would urge my Democratic colleagues to take that. That's the most Mitch can do. March the 5th will be here before you know it. March the 5th, 800,000 DACA recipients lose their legal status. And God help the Republican Party if we can't do something reasonable to help them.
Senator, are you here to pitch your three-week CR with this open immigration process to this group in there, or are you working with them on what they're working on?
This group is coming together around the idea that nobody wins a government shutdown. This is not about funding the troops or not caring about DACA. We all care about the troops. We all care about DACA recipients, or at least most of us do. It's trying to find a way to do something other than what the House did. The House sent us over a CR that was too long. General Mattis says that CRs are killing the military. I'm only agreeing to a CR of February the 8th because I believe that's enough time to get something done. The real breakthrough is when Senator McConnell said we're going to include immigration in the list of things to do. I couldn't agree with Mitch McConnell more. We're close on five issues that matter to the country. There are plenty of people in that room that want to start working on solving the problem, and the only way you can do that is to open the government.
Have you spoken to President Trump today at all?
No.
So, Fred, some important information relayed there by Senator Lindsey Graham. I do want to point out a couple of important things about what he had to say. He does sound optimistic, and he does feel as though he's gotten buy-in from some Democrats and some of his fellow Republicans. And he has said that Senator McConnell is willing to give on a couple of these points. But as much as they're interested in finding agreement among these rank-and-file members of the Senate, until there's buy-in from the leadership, this is really going nowhere. And to this point, the only time that Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell and Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer have even spoke was after they both gave those kind of scorched-earth speeches on the Senate floor this morning, and it was only for a very short period of time, and they essentially said that they are willing to open negotiations. So that's the first point. Even though he is optimistic, we have to couch that to a certain extent because of where leadership stands right now. The other important aspect of what Senator Graham talked about was the White House's involvement in all of this, and specifically the White House staff. And the criticism that he gave of Stephen Miller, one of the president's top aides, someone that has the ear of the president, saying that he is basically causing problems when it comes to these negotiations, and that the president is willing to cut a deal, but Miller and others are getting in his ear and telling him to back away, is causing part of the problem. And you have to wonder, Fred, if this is another example of a member of the United States Senate hoping to reach out to the president through the television airwaves and plead with him to say, listen, we have the opportunity to make a deal here. Mm-hmm. Stop listening to your staff. Start listening to us. It would not be a unique tactic for members of the U.S. Senate to go in that direction.
Right. Yeah. Blistering criticism of the president's staff. And as he was walking away, Lindsey Graham saying, no, he has not spoken with the president, but maybe by way of that chat with reporters there, he has. And he says he thinks more and more Democrats are believing this is not playing well for them. But he didn't necessarily say when the question was asked, have you brought more Democrats on board? It really does seem like it is a work in progress. But again, Ryan, you're right. It does sound like Senator Graham is rather hopeful, or at least optimistic. All right. Thank you so much. We'll check back with you. Still.